That's a pretty deep question, but I'll try to address it. I don't think anybody in this room wants to see government expand in certain unneeded. Back when that farm bill was passed, we had Fanaki with us every day. We had Paul with us every day. Fanaki's up here at the facility. And they were giving us all the information that was out there. Said, in fact, well, before we voted on that bill, we were there and watched it Saturday and Sunday for some like 8 straight days. That was the toughest one we ever took. Because I believe in the free enterprise system, I think it will work. But they told us that back in 1929, during the Depression, that the federal government would inject a few dollars into this monetary system, it wouldn't have collapsed. And I recall, I wasn't there, but my dad was. And I'm telling you, he never took out a bank account until after I finished high school. And so I felt like that we ought to try to do something to stabilize the banking industry, to be able to get people to loan money again. So I voted for the first $350 billion start. But then I saw what was happening with the, you know, with the administration we had now. They were just spending billions of dollars with other cars in the, you know, AIG and to Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. They were so. The second vote came for the other $350 billion. It wasn't a $700 billion bill. It was two parts of $350. I voted against it, and I voted against the stimulus, which is absolutely going to waste the money. Some $787 billion has been spent, and no jobs. You know, unemployment actually rose. Obama said when he passed that stimulus package, that the pension unemployment would never go above what?
8%.
8%. And where did it get to? 9.5%. We're not sure he's failed all the folks that's unemployed. So I'm just as concerned about it as you are, because somebody's going to have to pay the bill. And it's going to be you and your children and your grandchildren. So we've got to put a handle to it, but I'm telling you, we can't put a handle to it until the people in America turn this group away.
And turn the guards for civilian populations.
Relocation
and internment guards for civilian populations. That's on the computer. It's under the Army, and the Army work, whatever. What is the purpose of that?
I don't know.
FEMA camps.
Huh?
FEMA camps. They're going to start using the Patriot Act against people that speak out against the government.
And that's what concerns me.
Well, that really concerns me too. I know that he had some kind of a website up in Washington taking a list of all the people that opposed his health care. But I didn't know that he signed the guards to
it. It's on the Army website.
I'll take a look.
And the thing is that if we oppose, and I mean we're called racist, if we oppose anything the Democrats put up, if we oppose it, we're a racist. If we get together and we talk about it, or we get groups together like the 9/12 group or something
sure.
like that, they get these people and just round us all up and put us in internment camps.
I don't think that's going to happen.
Well, I wouldn't do anything past this, man.
I don't see it.
With these czars, all these czars he's appointed, how do we know what these czars are going to have in mind? We don't know. We have no control over it.
You're exactly right. We don't know where these czars are coming from either. They don't have to pass Senate scrutiny. You know, I'm as concerned about that as you are. They got